Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. Today, as the title says, we're going to make a no-touch alcohol dispenser using Velostat as the switch. The reason why I chose Velostat would be explained later. We'll start by making the prototype on a breadboard, discover some issues, resolve them, and then learn a thing or two in the process.
But dude, isn't it a bit, you know, too late?
Well, it is. Yes. Better late than never, I guess. And as always, all the necessary links, including the sources, codes, schematics, and other good stuff would be available on the description down below. Let's go! Here are the things that we need. An Arduino Nano. This is the one with the CH340 driver which you may or may not need to install before it can be detected. Just open the link in the description using Chrome so that you can translate it because the website is in Chinese. You can also use other Arduinos if you wish to do so. A 5V 10A relay module to control the pump's on and off state. Yes, if you have seen some of my previous Arduino projects, you may have seen this one already. The speaker module to signal that the alcohol is about to be dispensed. I used this one on a previous project where I used some bananas to play some tones. 3-5V mini submersible pump that would pump out the alcohol. A breadboard, of course. 5V DC adapter to provide power for the pump. The 5x8mm silicone tube for the pump. And this one, the Velostat sheet that would act as a pressure-sensitive switch that would activate the pump when a certain pressure value is reached.
But what is that? What is a Velostat?
Velostat, also known as Linkstat, is a packaging material made of polymeric foil impregnated with carbon black to make it electrically conductive. And, due to its properties of changing resistance with either flexing or pressure, it is becoming popular with hobbyists for making inexpensive sensors for microcontroller experiments. Thanks, Wikipedia. A soldering iron and soldering lead. A few hookup wires, female to male and male to male jumper cables, and some alligator clips. A wire stripper. Screwdriver. A few heat shrink tubes. And of course, the container for the alcohol plus a few more things that I forgot to include due to lack of foresight. First things first, let's solder some pin headers onto the Arduino Nano. Not my best soldering job, but I think it's good enough. Okay, I'm going to pause this for now, because the PCB that I've bought before was apparently the wrong one and I don't like it. I have already ordered a new set of blank PCBs, the green ones, with double-sided through holes. I know, I can just use this one for now, but eh! For the meantime, let's do some small-scale tests. For us to do that, we need to cut a small piece of Velostat. Get some hookup wires. And then, attach the hookup wires on each side of the Velostat with tape. Upload the code. Let's see what will happen. There you go. Oh, nothing's happening. Why? Well, it looks like this certain way of folding the hookup wire does not work at all. Looking back at the definition of what the Velostat is, I think it's simply overwhelming the analog pin of the MCU or confusing itself on what to transmit first or where to get data from because it has multiple points. Not sure though. Now that I have changed how the hookup wire is folded, let's see if it would work. Alright, let's launch VS Code. Here's the initial test code. Connect the Arduino. Let's check if it's detected. There it is on COM10. Click on Build, and then upload the code. Now let's click on Serial Monitor. As you can see, after touching the Velostat, the previously continuous 0 value on the serial monitor changed to 1. The way the code works is like this. The built-in LED which is set up as an output would light up when the pump has been turned on. The Velostat is connected to digital pin number 2 and is set up as an input to utilize the internal pull-up resistor. Digital pin number 2 would monitor the signal from the Velostat and then print it to the serial monitor in real time. And if the Velostat signal becomes high, it would then trigger the speaker module, which is connected to digital pin number 4 to generate a tone 3 times with a 300 milliseconds duration and 800 milliseconds of pauses each as a countdown before turning on the pump. Following the countdown tones generated by the speaker module, the built-in LED would light up and the relay would then turn on the pump for it to dispense alcohol for about 1 second and a 1 second delay before it starts the process again. And if the Velostat signal is low or zero, the pump and built-in LED would stay off. Just like this. So right now the initial test code is working. However, it's too sensitive and it activates the rest of the procedure no matter how lightly you touch it. I know that it's because of how I have written the code. I treated the Velostat as a switch and when the signal became high, it just does what it's supposed to. I think there are a few things that we can do or add to the code which can solve this issue. We can either add some millis or some sort of long press code to have a predetermined duration that the Velostat needs to be high or pressed before it moves on to the other parts of the program. Okay, here's the latest code iteration. Let's launch VS Code. Here it is. Plug in the Arduino. So everything is mostly the same as before except the code for the Velostat. Whoops, let's not forget to include the built-in LED to the loop. From digital pin number 2, I have moved the Velostat to analog pin number 7. Doing that can let us monitor the actual value it transmits and make adjustments accordingly. Think of it like if it changed the threshold to a higher value, it would need less flex or pressure to turn high. And when the sensor value reached the threshold, it would then turn on the built-in LED, print the value onto the serial monitor, and then proceed with the tone generation and turn on the pump. Alright, let's upload the code. Click on the serial monitor and let's see if it would work. There you go. Value that is greater than or equal to 100 is detected. Wait for 3 seconds.
1, 2, 3, turn on.
Then turn on the pump and built-in LED. Right. I have put the Velostat on the floor to actually test if it can be activated by stepping on it. And there you go. To do some more tests, I have filled up the water bottle with water, then connected the pump to the relay and prepared the thing that is called a tabo, or a dipper or a pitcher in English, to catch the water and not spill it on my desk. I have also hooked up my multimeter to the ground and positive terminals of the pump because I think the pump is broken. As you can see here, voltage is being received by the pump and it's not turning on. Let's try with the milliamps. So there's voltage and amperage, but it's still not working. Here I have replaced the pump with another one. Good thing I ordered a pair. Let's try it again. Step on the Velostat and there you go. Change the duration of the pump to 500 milliseconds as well. Here it is again. Step on the Velostat. 1, 2, 3. Marvelous. Well, the code is good enough, but it's still not quite how I imagined it to function. But we're getting there. After a few hours of research on better ways to use the Velostat as a switch, I found a downloadable PowerPoint presentation from the University of Wyoming and have decided to try it out. Here it is. Again, links in the description. Just follow along with me here, okay? So apparently, this is how Velostat works and this is why it's not functioning the way that I liked it to. Alright, let's cut off a new sheet of small Velostat, secure it with tape, and prepare an aluminum foil. Cut off the foil a few millimeters smaller than the Velostat and then put it on top. Again, secure it with tape. Then, repeat the steps to the other side of the Velostat. We also have to cut one end of the jumper cables and expose the copper wires and then secure it with tape onto the aluminum foil. Like this, and like this. According to the PowerPoint, adding an aluminum foil on both sides of the Velostat makes the Velostat's resistance directly related to pressure. After that, let's do some tests. The connections are like this. Ground to ground, analog pin 0 to this blank pin right here, then connect a 1k ohm resistor from 5 volts to analog pin 0 and then connect the other side of the Velostat to it. Adding a resistor makes the Velostat a variable resistor set up as a voltage divider. Now let's try the sample code. Here it is, plug in the Arduino, double check if it's being detected, there it is on COM10, then click on upload. After uploading the code, click on Serial Monitor. Okay, so supposedly the value of the sensor would decrease whenever I add pressure to the Velostat. See that? The value depends on how much pressure it receives or how hard I press the Velostat. To better visualize what happens when we increase the pressure that is applied to the Velostat, let's go ahead and launch the Arduino IDE, upload the code, and then open up Serial Plotter. There it is. As you can see, every time I apply pressure to the Velostat, the waveform on the Serial Plotter goes down, and if the sensor does not receive any pressure, it stays high. On this part, I have finally finished the code. So, basically, the code is the same as the initial test code, just with a few minor differences. Velostat is in analog pin number 0, just like the analog serial code from the IDE. I have moved the pump slash relay from digital pin number 3 to digital pin number 2. Moved the speaker from pin 4 to pin 3 as well. Setup is just about the same. On the void loop, I have set the sensor value or Velostat's value to be monitored by analog pin 0 and printed on the serial monitor every 2 milliseconds. And if the sensor value becomes less than 200 or if the right amount of pressure was applied to the Velostat, same as the previous test codes, it will then tell the speaker to generate the signal tone and countdown tones before turning on the pump. By utilizing the Velostat's pressure sensor capability, where the higher the amount of pressure it receives, the lower the value it gives, we can set a predefined sensor value or threshold for it to only activate when it detected the correct pressure value. By doing that, only a human can activate it because humans generally weigh more than dogs or cats and therefore can apply more pressure to the Velostat. Because I'm going to place the dispenser outside of our front door and sometimes the neighbor's dog or cat sleeps there. Obviously, I don't want them to accidentally bathe in alcohol or waste it, so this is perfect for the use case. Because if I have used the millis or long press code, it would still be activated by a cat or a dog if they slept on the Velostat and reached the defined duration, I think. Alright, let's upload the code. Whoop, hold on. Need to connect the Arduino first. Click on upload again. Let's see. There you go. Click on serial monitor. See, if I press on this no matter how long it takes, it does not turn on the pump because it's not receiving enough pressure. And if I press on it hard enough, the Velostat would trigger the whole process.
3 days later.
Now it's time for some soldering. Of course, we're going to need some protection from the fumes. Okay, here are the PCBs. I ordered 2 sets of double-sided FR4 protoboards. Each set has 5 pieces each. One set is 6x8cm and the other one is 8x12. These are from Maker Lab Electronics, by the way. Alright, first thing we need to do is see if everything would fit. So we're going to need to leave a space here for the relay and speaker's digital input pins. A0 for the Velostat, and from A0, connect it to ground at 5 volts. The 5 volts pin would need 3 pins for the relay or pump, speaker, and the Velostat. Same thing with the ground pin. Again, all the necessary links including the sources, codes, and schematics would be available in the description down below. Then we're going to attach the relay right here and the speaker module right here. Looks like everything would fit. We're also going to need some female pin headers or legs for the Arduino Nano for us to be able to reuse it for other projects. Alright, let's turn on the soldering iron and wait for it to heat up. While waiting for the soldering iron to heat up, I went ahead and cut the female pin headers to length and still have a few more left to use for other connections. And to hold the PCB, I'm going to use this thing. To hold the female pin headers and keep it steadily attached to the PCB, I'm going to use a rubber band. Alright, cue the montage! After a few minor soldering errors and troubleshooting, I have finally managed to finish it, and instead of drilling holes for the relay and speaker standoffs, I used hot glue to save time and possibly reuse the PCB in the future. Okay, now let's see if it would still work. I'm going to step on the Velostat now.
There you go.
I also have changed the delay time, so that after turning off the pump, the Velostat would turn off as well for about 10 seconds before activating again. As you can see, just like on my PC, the cable management on the front is not too shabby. However, if you take a look at the backside,
there is chaos!
So this is the ground, 5 volts, and data pin of the speaker module. And if you take a look here, You can see this blob of solder that is acting as a bridge to connect the three 90 degree pin headers to the ground pin of the Arduino. So it looks like this. I have soldered it onto the front side of the PCB and can't figure out how to connect it to ground. And instead of redoing the whole thing on another board, which is a waste of both time and resources, I took the easier and more economical path and just bridged it. I know it's janky, but it works. I have also secured the jumper cables to the board using hot glue, because it would be a pain to reconnect them if they have been disconnected and the board is already placed inside the enclosure. I have also bent or made the hookup wires squiggly like this, so that it won't be easily pulled or disconnected from the alligator clips. For the enclosure, since I can't find the proper one that would fit the whole thing, I'm thinking of just using this box. I mean, it can easily fit everything inside and I can just throw it away when the time comes. It's also recyclable, which is a plus. Just need to make a hole at the top for the bottle and some holes for the wires. By using a 9mm drill bit, I have managed to make an off-centered hole on the cap for both the tube and the pump's wires. Alright, let's see. Sorry about that. Okay, I made a hole right here for the bottle and pass-through hole right here for the USB, power supply, and Velostat's cable as well. I'm thinking of maybe just attaching the board right here using hot glue, and these jumper cables right here would be connected to the Velostat, aka pressure sensitive switch, which are also secured by hot glue. Just attach the board to the enclosure. Then, I have wrapped it with a gift wrapper, but I used the backside so that it looks cleaner. Did not wrap the bottom of it though. Here's the flap for the pass-through hole for the wires, and this big hole for the bottle. Now that everything is ready on the enclosure, let's go ahead and fill this bottle with alcohol. Since I can find a gallon of 70% isopropyl, I'm just going to use ethyl alcohol for this. Alright, now let's put it inside the enclosure, connect everything, and then just stuff the cables inside. The reason why I kept the bottle exposed is to easily see if it needs to be refilled. I have also attached a thread to the tube to hold it in place. Just like that. Now it's time for some final tests. Let's connect the Velostat, there you go, plug these things in, and step on it. 3, 2, 1, oh no, that's not good. What? Well, it looks like we need to reduce the on state of the pump for it not to dispense too much alcohol and also reposition the tube so that it wouldn't suddenly turn into a siphon and keep on dispensing alcohol even if the pump is off. So, I have just changed the on-state duration of the pump from 500 milliseconds down to 200. I have also adjusted the position of the tube. And now, let's see how it would go. Step on the Velostat. And there you go. Perfect. In conclusion, compared to the readily available automatic alcohol dispensers on the market, which are, not gonna lie, way cooler looking than this one, this is cheaper to build. I mean, assuming that you already have most of the items to make it, it's actually really easy to make as well. Just need a few components, a few code revisions, and voila! Also, the feeling of pride mixed with happiness and relief that you get when you finally finish and made something work just like how you imagined it to work is priceless. I think I might replace the enclosure of it with a proper one when I happen to find some, but for now, this is fine. And I don't know what to say anymore, so I'm just going to end this right here. Thanks for watching and see you again next week. Maybe.